I think one of the biggest problems that we face in our society, in our day and age, in our generation, whatever you want to consider it, is we really try to hide the truth from people. We've grown up in this world where everything is fair. Everybody gets a trophy. Nobody is left behind. Nobody is different. Don't get me wrong, I'm all for being equal, you know, treating people equally. But the thing is, as humans, we are different. We see things differently. We feel things differently sometimes. Although we can relate to other people, we are not all the same. As human beings, we take losses. And I think in today's world where we grow up and it's more normal to not let somebody understand that they took a loss is really negative. It creates room for people to start making excuses. It gives a reason for people to start pointing the finger in other directions for not taking responsibility for themselves. At the end of the day, if you're not happy where you are, it's your problem. The circumstances could be different compared to other people. You could have definitely been dealt a shitty hand. Trust me, I understand. My life isn't perfect. It's never gonna be perfect. It's never been perfect. But at the end of the day, I had full control over my situation. If you're not happy with where you are, if you're not happy with what you're doing, it's pretty fucking simple. Stop doing it. I mean, sure, yeah, it gets scary, it gets challenging, it's risky, and you never know what's going to happen. But at the end of the day, isn't that why we are alive? To experience this opportunity that we're given, and not just sit by and watch it go to waste? Overall, your goals, your ambitions, and your objectives are yours. But so is the outcome and the process. If you want it to happen, you can make it happen. If you don't, you won't. So stop blaming other people for your faults. Be honest with yourself. If you know me by now, I'm not somebody that's all about like, oh, new year, new me. But one of the things that's easily able to look at is just what you've done in a previous year. A lot of situations, a lot of people just kind of look at a new year as an opportunity to just say, okay, these are the things I didn't do correctly this year. And now moving into the next year, I'm going to do the things that are going to make me better. But 2017, man, a big year for all of us, the world, honestly. So many crazy things happened this year with social media being with everybody nowadays. It was so easy to see all the terrible that went on this year, you know what I mean? Sometimes it's nice to just kind of take a second and remember all the good things that actually happened in the year. I know for myself, I was able to express what I love doing for a living in a way that brought me into a new creative field. This videography, photography stuff. My passion for my work as a freelance designer helped influence me this year to start stepping out of the comfort zone, I guess, with other things. And it's now led me to this extremely costly addiction in the video world, which is, it's awesome because I get to document these moments. Hopefully years to come, I'll be able to look back on this video recapping 2017 and be like, man, 2017, good year, good year. You know, all the way from just traveling more this year, living a little bit, experiencing life to proposing to Megan. Thank God she said yes, by the way. Down to all the people that I got to meet this year and hopefully influence to chase after the things that they want to do as well.
Stick to your stones, cause that's all you know. I was caught in the middle. I swallow my words down to the bone. Cause nothing's that simple. Late at night, you.
guys that I met this year are amazing people. You truly are. The positivity, the interaction that you guys bring, you're way too special and creative to not push forward in 2018. Please push forward in 2018. You guys are amazing. And this also goes to all the people that I haven't met yet. There's tons of people out there with a creative imagination and a desire to do something that they want to do, and they hold themselves back from doing it, or they wait till the next year to try to do it. Just do it now, guys. I want to take the opportunity to remind the people of some of the positive things that the YouTube creators have done this year. All the fundraising that's gone on during the drought, for example, or people losing loved ones, taking the opportunity to use their fan base to actually give back. How amazing is that? That we're in a world now where people have the opportunity to create their own content, benefit from it, and then also give back to the world from it. It's mind-blowing. We've definitely lost some amazing people this year, some amazing musicians, at least on my end, some musicians that really inspired me throughout the years to just be the person that I am today. But even with losing them, it gave us an opportunity to remember a lot of the music, remember a lot of those old feelings that drove us to create the path that we created today. If you look back at every single year as a marking point of what's happened in your life, it's going to have ups and downs, guys. For some of you, 2017 wasn't a great year. Bad things happened. Maybe you lost a loved one. And I'm truly, truly sorry for that. If you could find any part of you to just look at the good things that did happen this year and just focus on those things, even if it's the littlest stuff, to just help push forward, I promise you things will turn around. Looking back throughout multiple years, I've been at many low points too. I've lost people, I've had bad times, I've been through depression and stress and just felt so alone. I can honestly say I've made the best of 2017. It's had ups and downs, but during those down times, I focused on a lot of the positive that I have. I focused on a lot of the hard work that I could put in, and I did it. Here in a few weeks, I'm going to be creating a short film of kind of like an anniversary of me quitting my job to be a freelance designer. I look forward to doing this video because I did one last year, and it's just going to be insane seeing the transition of how I created content then to now. If I actually remember correctly, my first ever short film was the I Quit My Job to Be a Freelance Designer. It's really cold out here. It's so cold out here. You guys better appreciate this video in some way, shape, or form, because I'm freezing my ass off to be out here and get this, but it's so worth it, because this is where a lot of this type of stuff started for me, this documenting, this getting out and doing stuff. In 2 days, it's 2018, and I'm gonna head into 2018 not remembering how great of a year 2017 was for me, not remembering the bad things that happened in 2017, but just realizing that no matter what year it is, as long as I'm still here, I have the opportunity to live, and I wanna take advantage of that to the best of my ability. I wanna thank everybody who's been a part of this year, all the way down to the co-workers at Creative Grenade, all the customers that we've had this year, all the supporters and the videos and the live streams, Megan, family, friends, anybody that's just been a positive influence in this year, anybody that's been a negative influence as well. Thank you for pissing me off so much, so that way I gave the opportunity to prove you guys wrong. Take every opportunity you guys get and make something of it, because we never know what year is going to be our last. Here's to 2018.